z parameters of the given circuit. All right, so V1, four parameters are there: V1, V2, I1 and I2. V1 is the terminal input voltage, I1 is the terminal input current, V2 is the output voltage, I2 is the output current. All right, so first thing is set I2 as 0. I2 as 0 means open circuit the port number 2, redraw the circuit. So open circuit the port 2 means here I2 is 0. If I2 is 0 means all these things can be, these two wires can be neglected here, so that it is redrawn here. And we have assumed two more currents here. The current through 120 ohm resistor is IV, then current through this branch is IA. Alright, so what is V1 here? This V1 is nothing but voltage drop across this 120 ohm resistance. V1 is nothing but the voltage drop across this 120 ohm resistance. So V1 equals to what is current flowing through this branch? It is IB. Voltage equals to IB into 120. That is written here. Then let us calculate IB using current divider rule. Current divider rule. So if this is the current, total current I, and I1 is the current flowing through R1, I2 is the current flowing through R2, then the value I1 equals to total current into opposite resistance divided by total resistance R1 plus R2. Similarly, how to calculate this I2? If it is a circuit, if it is a parallel circuit, then current I2 can be calculated as total current, this is the total current I, into opposite resistance for this branch is R1 divided by sum of the resistors R1 plus R2. Same thing. So you can compare in the place of I here I1, in the place of I1 here it is IB, in the place of I2 here it is IA. Alright, so IB can be calculated as total current I1 into opposite resistance. Opposite resistance is a sum of these two here. Keep this point in your mind. Alright, so from here to here, we observed only one resistance here. But from here to here, we are observing a sum of resistors. We are observing sum of resistors so that current IB can be written as total current into opposite resistance. Opposite resistance is 240 plus 40. It is 280 divided by sum of resistors. 240 plus 40 plus 180. Sorry, 120. That is what? 400. That is written here. Now, substitute this IB in this equation. So, that form 120 into 240 divided by 400 into I1. Do simplify. We will get 84. So V1 divided by I1, after simplification what we'll get here? So V1 equals to, in this case, after substituting what we'll get? V1 equals to 84 into I1. What is V1 by I1? That is equals to 84. What is V1 by I1? That is what? Z11. That is calculated here. Alright. Now, what is this V2? This V2 is nothing but voltage drop across a 240 ohm resistance. So, what is voltage? Current into a resistance. Current is IA, resistance is 240. So, that V2 equals to 240 into IA. Similarly, how to calculate this IA? Using again current divider rule. Using current divider rule, this IA equals to total current opposite resistance divided by a sum of the resistors. So IA equals to total current is I1, opposite resistance is 120 divided by sum of resistors 120 plus 240 plus 40. It is 400. Again, substitute this IA in this equation. We will get V2 equals to 72 into I1. What is V2 divided by I1? what is v2 divided by i1? V2 divided by i1. V2 divided by i1 equals to 72. That is nothing but Z21. That is the definition of a Z21. All right. Can you reply me? Have you understood how to calculate Z11 and Z21? First, apply the voltage divider voltage, calculate the voltage V1, calculate the voltage V2. That gives the value of Z11 and Z21. All right. Next, let us open circuit the port number 1. It can be open circuited. That means I1 equals to 0. So redraw the circuit. Actually, previously it was like this. And here I1 current was flowing. So that it can be removed here. All right. And it is I2 and it is V2. And we assumed two more currents. That is IY and IX. We assumed two more currents here. Actually, IY and IX were not given. So we assumed for the simplicity. Alright. Okay. Next thing is, first let us calculate V2. What is this V2? Is this voltage drop across this 240 ohm resistance? Yeah. So what is V2? 240 into IX. That is written here. What is IX? Again, use current division rule. Current through this branch equals to total current into opposite resistance divided by sum of the resistance. So this Ix is given by total current is here I2 in this case, I2 into opposite resistance, that is 120 plus 40. This 40 should not be neglected because between these two ports, the total resistance of branch is 240 plus 120 plus 40. So that Ix equals to total current into opposite resistance, 120 plus 40, it is 160, divided by sum of the resistance, 120 plus 40 plus 240, that is again 400. Substitute this Ix in this equation, we will get V2 equals to 96 into I2. What is V2 by I2? It is 96. Is this nothing but a Z22? And don't forget to write O. Alright, next is what? We want Z12. So what is V1? V1 equals to 120 into IY. What is IY? Again, use current divider rule. IY, current through this branch equals to, current through this branch equals to, so opposite resistance into total current divided by sum of the current. IY equals to, IY equals to, total current is I2 into opposite resistance is 240 divided by sum of the resistance, which is 400. Then substitute this I, Y in this equation. Then do simplify. We will get V1 equals to 72 into I2. So I can write V1 divided by I2 equals to Z12, that is equals to 72 ohm. All right. So that. So this is what the impedance matrix. This is what the impedance matrix, and this is the condition for symmetry, and this is the condition for reciprocal. Then okay, observe here. Here it is Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22. Z12 is 72, Z21 is 72. Then the given network is reciprocal. Then Z11 equals to Z22, Z11 and Z22, they are not equal, so that it is not reciprocal in nature. The given network is reciprocal in nature but not asymmetrical. I repeat, the given network is reciprocal in nature but not symmetrical in nature. All right. Okay, so let us write its equivalent circuit. It should be wrong, and here you should write the values. Here it is 84 and here it is 9. 72. What is Z2 here? Z2 is 96. 96 ohm, and it is 84 ohm. And 72 and 72. Here it is 72 ohm, and here it is 72 ohm. And at the end of every problem, this equivalent circuit should be written. Don't forget to write it, because it carries some marks, either 1 or 2 marks. It will be carried. All right. Then I will tell you the one more method to solve this problem. So is it in a delta? Is it in delta mode? Yeah, I do convert this into star. First, second, and a third. This delta can be converted into star here using this formula. So this is delta, and its equivalent star can be calculated using this formula. All right. So this value, call this as R1, call this as R3, call this as R2. All right. This R1 equals to RB into RC, means to this node, two resistors, 120 and 240, are connected, so that they should be multiplied. 120 into 240 divided by sum of resistors. Already we have calculated it. 120 plus 40 is 160. 160 plus 240, is that 400? All right. Then what is R2? R2 is 40 into 240. 40 into 240 divided by 400. What is R3? R3 equals to, this is R3, this is connected to this node, and multiply these two resistors. 120 into 40 divided by 400. So that, tell me the value here. 4 1s are 4 3s are. Is that 60? And is that 72 ohm? Is that 72 ohm? All right. Now this, okay, this 4 and this 4 can be cancelled. Is that 24 ohm? All right. This 4, is that 12 ohm? All of you got the same answers. 72, 24 and 12. And I will redraw the circuit here. I will redraw the circuit. It is I1 as it is. And R1 value is 72. And R3 value is 12. And R2 value is 24. All right. So that from this point, I2 is there. Okay. Is that the network? And here it is V1, and here it is V2. It can be simplified as, it can be rewritten as, is that the circuit now? They are one and the same. It is V1. It is I1, it is V2, it is I2. That's fine. Value is 72, it is 12, and it is 24. Okay, so what I will do, apply KVL for mesh 1. Is that the mesh 1? Okay, you can see here, this current I1 is entering, this current is flowing in this direction, I2 is flowing in this direction. Through this 72 ohm resistance, both I1 and I2 currents are flowing. So that I2 go in this direction, so that minus V1 plus 72 into I1 plus I2. Because in this 72 ohm resistance, both I1 and I2 current are flowing. but and also they are in same direction. And in 12 ohm resistance, only I1 current is flowing, that is equals to 0. I can simplify this as V1 equals to number of I1 are here, number of I1 are here. Here it is 84 I1 plus 72 I2. Call this as equation number 1. Then apply KVL to mesh 2. Okay, so here I will write here minus V2 plus I1 plus I2 into 72 plus 24 into I2, that is equals to 0. Then it can be simplified as V2 equals to number of I1, here it is 72 I1 plus 72 plus 24, is that 96 I2? Call this as equation number 2. Box these two equations. Box these two equations, and we know that what is V1? Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. What is V2? Z22 I1 plus Z22 I2. Then compare these equations with the equation number 1 and 2. In LHS, V1, V1. In RHS, I1, I2, Z11, Z12. In the place of Z11, 84 is there. Just by a comparison, I can say that Z11 equals to 84 ohm. So Z12 equals to 72 ohm. Then from this equation, V2, V2 is there. I1 and I2 are there. Then Z22 is nothing but 72. Sorry, Z, here it is Z1. Z21, here it is Z21 equals to again 72 ohm. And Z22 equals to 96 ohm. So that in a simple method, I will get Z parameters. The key point is a circuit can be anything. Convert it into a star. Apply KVL to first mesh, apply KVL to second mesh, then write the standard equations and compare them and write the values of Z parameters. The key point in Z parameters is convert the resistor circuit into the T circuit or else a star circuit. Apply KVL to mesh 1, apply KVL to mesh 2, write those two equations, compare with the standard equations, then write the values of Z11, Z12, Z21, and Z22.